हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग। माय सेल्फ श्री के डी बोरसे सर, बायोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट टीचर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी लर्न एक्सक्रेशन एंड ऑस्मोरेगुलेशन चैप्टर कंटेंट कंसेप्ट्स, सम डिसऑर्डर्स एंड डिसीजेस ऑफ किडनी। अल्सो वी डिटेल डिस्कस इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर हीमोडायलाइसिस, पेरिटोनियल डायलाइसिस, किडनी ट्रांसप्लांट। इन दैट टू टाइप्स ऑफ किडनी ट्रांसप्लांट, कैडेवरिक और डिसीज्ड डोनर किडनी ट्रांसप्लांट एंड लिविंग डोनर किडनी ट्रांसप्लांट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एलिवन साइंस बायोलॉजी सिलेबस कंटेंट चैप्टर नंबर 13, रेस्पिरेशन एंड एनर्जी ट्रांसफर। इन दैट वी डिटेल डिस्कस फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एटीपी। फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एटीपी मीन्स फॉस्फोराइलेशन। देर आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फॉस्फोराइलेशन मीन्स फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एटीपी इन डिटेल डिस्कस इन दिस लेक्चर। वी ऑल्सो लर्न कंसेप्ट ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन। There are two types of respiration in presence of free molecular oxygen, aerobic respiration in absence of free molecular oxygen and anaerobic respiration. So let us start today's first concept, formation of ATP. Before that, some basic information about respiration. Some basic information about respiration. In that first question, which nutrients are used for energy production? Carbohydrate, protein, fat are different types of nutrients are used for energy production. Which is the most preferred nutrient among carbohydrate, protein and fat for energy production? Carbohydrate is most important preferred nutrient among the carbohydrate, protein and fat, because carbohydrate is easily available and easily acceptable to the organisms. So, most preferred nutrient among all these three known as carbohydrate, and it is essential because it is easily available and easily acceptable to the organism. So, carbohydrate is most preferred nutrients. Why do organism take up oxygen and release carbon dioxide? Organisms take up oxygen from air, which is most important for oxidation of substrate to release the energy, and such energy is most valuable for each and every living cells. The released energy is most valuable to metabolism processes. During this, CO2 is released in the cell. Such CO2 is removed from body, is released carbon dioxide, and oxygen is taken, is most valuable. Up to this, we detail discuss three different questions about the respiration. Now question number 4, what is aerobic and anaerobic respiration? In aerobic respiration, free molecular oxygen is used. In anaerobic respiration, free molecular oxygen is not used. This is the difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. No doubt, both processes, release of energy from substrates. Which steps are involved in aerobic respiration? There are different steps involved in aerobic respiration. Glycolysis is the first step of aerobic respiration. No doubt glycolysis is involved in aerobic as well as anaerobic respiration. So, first step involved in aerobic respiration known as glycolysis. Second, link reaction, that is acetylation of pyruvic acid, is the second step of aerobic respiration. Third one is Krebs cycle, and fourth one is electron transfer system, that is terminal oxidation. Means there are four different steps involved in aerobic respiration. Up to this we detail discuss some basic information of respiration. Now we learn formation of ATP. How form ATP? You know, ATP is most valuable for living cell because ATP provide energy to living cell. So formation of ATP is most important process. We detail discuss how form ATP. Formation of ATP called as phosphorylation. Phosphorylation means formation of ATP. In nature, phosphorylation occurs in three different ways. Nature madhe phosphorylation teen way ne occurs hota. Number one, first, photophosphorylation is one of the phosphorylation process. Second, substrate level phosphorylation, and third, oxidative phosphorylation. There are three different ways of phosphorylation. Each way perform formation of ATP. Means there are three different types of formation of ATP. Photophosphorylation, substrate level phosphorylation, oxidative phosphorylation. We detail discuss one by one. First one is photophosphorylation. What is photophosphorylation? Formation of ATP by phosphorylation of ADP. Formation of ATP by phosphorylation of ADP occurs in the chloroplast in presence of light, called as photophosphorylation. Photophosphorylation is one of the type of formation of ATP. In that, phosphorylation of ADP means ADP phosphorylation kela jato in the chloroplast madhe. And presence of light is most important. So such type of phosphorylation called as photophosphorylation. Photo means light, in presence of light. In the chloroplast, phosphorylation process takes place, that is ADP phosphorylation to form ATP. Such process called as photophosphorylation. What is main purpose of photophosphorylation? Formation of ATP is the main purpose of photophosphorylation, in which location occurs photophosphorylation in the cell. In the cell, in chloroplast, photophosphorylation occurs, which is the most characteristic feature of photophosphorylation. Photophosphorylation done only in presence of light in the chloroplast is most characteristic features of photophosphorylation. Up to this we detail discuss. Photophosphorylation is one of the formation of ATP process, one of the phosphorylation process. Hope that you understood everything. Now we learn Second type of phosphorylation known as substrate level phosphorylation. What is substrate level phosphorylation? A process of formation of ATP by direct phosphorylation of ADP. Always remember, it is also process of ATP formation, but direct phosphorylation of ADP by transfer of phosphate groups. ADP phosphorylation by transfer of phosphate group from any suitable substrate occurs in cytoplasm of the cell and mitochondria matrix part. Such phosphorylation called as substrate level phosphorylation, in that direct phosphorylation of ADP process takes place. Hyachat aplyala phosphorylation of ADP is direct hotanna disel. By transfer of a phosphate group, ek phosphate group transfer hoto from any suitable substrate. Such processes occurs in cytoplasm of the cell as well as matrix of the mitochondria. So such type of phosphorylation called as substrate level phosphorylation. What is the main purpose of substrate level phosphorylation? Formation of ATP. Why substrate level phosphorylation called as direct phosphorylation? Because in this type of phosphorylation, transfer of phosphate group from any suitable substrate directly. So phosphorylation of ADP is converted into ATP, so called them direct phosphorylation. In which location occurs substrate level phosphorylation in the cell? Cytoplasm of the cell occurs in substrate level phosphorylation as well as matrix of the mitochondria. So cytoplasm of the cell as well as matrix of mitochondria occurs in substrate level phosphorylation. Up to this we detail discuss substrate level phosphorylation is one of the process of formation of ATP. Hope that you understood everything. Now we learn third type of phosphorylation known as oxidative phosphorylation. What is oxidative phosphorylation? Oxidative phosphorylation is also a process of formation of ATP by phosphorylation of ADP. He dekhil ek ADP phosphorylation process hai, in that using energy released during oxidation of substrate. Ya process madhe एनर्जी रिलीज होते. सच एनर्जी इज यूज फॉर फॉस्फोराइलेशन ऑफ एडीपी. सच एनर्जी इज रिलीज ड्यूरिंग द ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ सबस्ट्रेट्स लाइक एनएडीएच प्लस हाइड्रोजन मीन्स निकोटिनामाइड एडेनाइन डायन्यूक्लियोटाइड हाइड्राइड्स एनएडीएच निकोटिनामाइड एडेनिन डायन्यूक्लियोटाइड हाइड्राइड्स प्लस हाइड्रोजन इज वन ऑफ द सबस्ट्रेट. अल्सो FADS2 मीन्स फ्लैविन एडेनिन डायन्यूक्लियोटाइड हाइड्राइड्स. दिस टू सबस्ट्रेट्स ऑक्सीडाइज टू रिलीज एनर्जी. सच एनर्जी इज यूजफुल फॉर phosphorylation of ADP, and this process is occurs in inner mitochondrial membrane only. So such process called as oxidative phosphorylation. What is the main purpose of oxidative phosphorylation? Formation of ATP is the main purpose of oxidative phosphorylation, in which location occurs oxidative phosphorylation. Inner mitochondrial membrane occurs only in oxidative phosphorylation. What is main characteristic feature of oxidative phosphorylation? Phosphorylation of ADP using energy released during the oxidation of substrate by NADH plus hydrogen and FADS2. So this is the most important characteristic feature of oxidative phosphorylation. Up to this we detail discuss oxidative phosphorylation. Means there are three different types of phosphorylation. First one is photophosphorylation. Second one is substrate level phosphorylation. And third one is oxidative phosphorylation. Each and every one, the main purpose is formation of ATP. Up to this we detail discuss formation of ATP in different ways. Now we learn some questions about ATP. First question: when energy is required, the cell require energy during the metabolism. जेव्हा metabolism करायचं असतं तेव्हा सेलला एनर्जी गरजेची असते. सो व्हेन मेटाबॉलिझम टेक्स प्लेस ॲट दॅट टाईम सेल रिक्वायर एनर्जी. इन विच फॉर्म एनर्जी रिक्वायर टू द सेल? यस, एटीपी फॉर्म एनर्जी रिक्वायर टू द सेल. इन सेलला एनर्जी एटीपीच्या फॉर्ममध्ये गरजेची असते. सो सेल रिक्वायर एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एटीपी. हाऊ एनर्जी प्रोव्हाइड फ्रॉम एटीपी टू सेल? एटीपी पासून सेलला एनर्जी कशी मिळत असेल? एटीपी हायड्रोलायसिस टू रिलीज एनर्जी. एटीपी हायड्रोलायसिस होते, एनर्जी रिलीज होते. सो ए टी पी हायड्रोलायसिस टू रिलीज एनर्जी यूजफुल फॉर मेटाबॉलिक ऍक्टिव्हिटी ऑफ द सेल. अप टू दिस वी डिटेल डिस्कस सम क्वेश्चन्स अबाउट ए टी पी. नव वी लर्न सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ ए टी पी. वॉट आर द सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ ए टी पी? नंबर वन, फर्स्ट सिग्निफिकन्स, ए टी पी प्रोव्हाइड एनर्जी टू व्हेरियस लाईफ प्रोसेसेस ऑफ द सेल. सेलमध्ये ज्या वेगवेगळ्या लाईफ प्रोसेसेस होतात त्यांच्यासाठी ए टी पी प्रोव्हाइड करते एनर्जी. सो ए टी पी इज मोस्ट व्हॅल्युएबल टू द सेल. ए टी पी डोनेट फॉस्फेट ग्रुप्स इन सम बायोकेमिकल रिएक्शन ऑकर्स इन द सेल. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, ए टी पी डोनेट करतो फॉस्फेट ग्रुप इन सम बायोकेमिकल रिएक्शन. दॅट रिएक्शन ऑकर्स इन द लिविंग सेल. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ ए टी पी. नाव थर्ड सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ ए टी पी. ए टी पी इज नीडेड फॉर सिंथेसिस ऑफ बायोमॉलिक्युल्स. बायोमॉलिक्युल सिंथेसिस करण्यासाठी ए टी पी नीडेड असतो. यू नो, सेल कंटेन बायोमॉलिक्युल्स लाईक डी एन ए, आर एन ए आर सिंथेसाइज बाय ए टी पी एनर्जी. सो ए टी पी नीडेड फॉर सिंथेसिस ऑफ बायोमॉलिक्युल्स इज वन ऑफ द सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ ए टी पी. ए टी पी हायड्रोलायसिस टू रिलीज एनर्जी. ए टी पी हायड्रोलायसिस होते, एनर्जी रिलीज होते आणि यूज फॉर मेटाबॉलिक ॲक्टिव्हिटी ऑफ द सेल. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ ए टी पी. हेअर नोटेड ऑल दिस डिफरंट फोर सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ ए टी पी. अप टू दिस वी डिटेल डिस्कस फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एटीपी, सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ एटीपी. नाउ वी लर्न रेस्पिरेशन, कंसेप्ट ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन. व्हाट इज रेस्पिरेशन? रेस्पिरेशन इज अ कैटाबोलिक प्रोसेस, मीन्स ब्रेकडाउन प्रोसेस. कैटाबोलिक प्रोसेस मीन्स ब्रेकडाउन प्रोसेस. सो रेस्पिरेशन इज कैटाबोलिक प्रोसेस इन विच कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गेनिक सबस्ट्रेट इज ऑक्सीडाइज्ड टू सिंपल कंपोनेंट्स. रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस मध्ये कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गेनिक सबस्ट्रेट ऑक्सीडाइज्ड होतो टू सिंपल कंपोनेंट्स. त्याचे सिंपल कंपोनेंट्स तयार होतात टू रिलीज बायोलॉजिकल एनर्जी, अँड रिलीज होते बायोलॉजिकल एनर्जी. सच प्रोसेस कॉल्ड ॲज रेस्पिरेशन. मीन्स रेस्पिरेशन इज कॅटॅबोलिक प्रोसेस इन विच कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट ऑक्सिडाइज टू सिंपल कंपोनंट्स टू रिलीज बायोलॉजिकल एनर्जी. सच प्रोसेस कॉल्ड ॲज रेस्पिरेशन. रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेसमध्ये ब्रेकडाऊन होणार, काय ब्रेकडाऊन होईल? तर ऑर्गॅनिक कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट, आणि ब्रेकडाऊन झालेला कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट ऑक्सिडाइज्ड झाल्यानंतर इट फॉर्म्स सिंपल कंपोनंट्स, अँड ड्युरिंग दिस बायोलॉजिकल एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एटीपी इज रिलीज. सो सच प्रोसेस कॉल्ड ॲज रेस्पिरेशन. व्हाय रेस्पिरेशन इज कॅटाबोलिक प्रोसेस? बिकॉज इन रेस्पिरेशन कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट इज ब्रेकडाऊन, हेन्स रेस्पिरेशन इज कॅटाबोलिक प्रोसेस. व्हाट इज मेन पर्पज ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन? रिलीज ऑफ एनर्जी फ्रॉम कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट, अँड सच एनर्जी इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एटीपी विच इज मोस्ट व्हॅल्युएबल टू लिव्हिंग सेल. सो रेस्पिरेशन इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट प्रोसेस. सेल्युलर रेस्पिरेशन ऑकर्स इन टू डिफरंट वेज. नंबर वन, फर्स्ट एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन, अँड सेकंड एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. मीन्स सेलमध्ये होणारं रेस्पिरेशन दोन टाईपचं असतं, एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन अँड एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. मीन्स इन प्रेझेन्स ऑफ फ्री मॉलिक्युलर ऑक्सिजन रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस ऑकर्स कॉल्ड ॲज एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. इन ॲबसेन्स ऑफ फ्री मॉलिक्युलर ऑक्सिजन रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस ऑकर्स, सच प्रोसेस कॉल्ड ॲज एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. वी डिटेल डिस्कस डिफरंट बिटवीन एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन अँड एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन. व्हॉट इज डिफरंट बिटवीन एनएरोबिक अँड एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन? एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इज अ सेल्युलर रेस्पिरेशन इन विच कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट ब्रेकडाऊन विदाउट फ्री मॉलिक्युलर ऑक्सिजन कॉल्ड ॲज एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन, अल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज फर्मंटेशन. एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन ही देखील सेल्युलर रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस आहे. या प्रोसेसमध्ये इन विच कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट ब्रेकडाऊन केला जातो विदाउट फ्री मॉलिक्युलर ऑक्सिजन. कोणत्याही फ्री मॉलिक्युलर ऑक्सिजन शिवाय कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट ब्रेकडाऊन केला जातो. सो कॉल्ड देम एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन, अल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज फर्मंटेशन. वाय एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन अल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज फर्मंटेशन? बिकॉज इन दिस रेस्पिरेशन इज टेक्स प्लेस विथ द हेल्प ऑफ मायक्रो ऑर्गॅनिझम रिलीज एन्झाईम. सच एन्झाईम इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कॉम्प्लेक्स ऑर्गॅनिक सबस्ट्रेट ब्रेकडाऊन. सो कॉल्ड देम फर्मंटेशन. Why this respiration called as anaerobic respiration? Because this respiration occurs without free molecular oxygen, so called them anaerobic respiration. In anaerobic respiration, the glucose molecule, means C6H12O6, that is glucose molecule, is broken down or oxidized to form, means give release, with the help of microorganism release enzyme. Twice C2H5OH, means ethyl alcohol, plus 2 CO2 molecule plus 2 ATP molecule, means in anaerobic respiration without oxygen, glucose is breakdown to form ethyl alcohol molecule plus 2 molecule of CO2 molecule plus 2 molecule C6H12O6 gives twice C2H5OH ethyl alcohol plus 2 CO2 plus 2 ATP molecules are formed during the anaerobic respiration or fermentation. In aerobic respiration, it is also a cellular respiration in which complex organic substrate break down with free molecular oxygen, called as aerobic respiration. Why this type of respiration called as aerobic respiration? Because in this type of respiration occurs with free molecular oxygen, so called as aerobic respiration. In that aerobic respiration, one glucose molecule, means C6H12O6, with the help of six oxygen molecule oxidized the one glucose molecule, gives 6 CO2 molecule plus 6 H2O molecule plus 38 ATP molecule, means this type of respiration is occurs with the help of free molecular oxygen, and so called them aerobic respiration. In this type of respiration, the released product are very simple and more energy is produced, like 38 ATP. So this is the difference between anaerobic and aerobic respiration. In anaerobic respiration without free molecular oxygen takes place respiration process. Aerobic respiration in presence of free molecular oxygen respiration process occurs. Anaerobic respiration produces from a single glucose molecule only 2 ATP. Aerobic respiration, only single glucose molecule produces 38 ATP. So this is different between anaerobic and aerobic respiration. Hope that you understood everything. Now we learn some more point about anaerobic and aerobic respiration. Here the reaction of anaerobic respiration, also here noted reaction of aerobic respiration. It occurs, means anaerobic respiration occurs in cytoplasm only. Aerobic respiration occurs in cytoplasm as well as mitochondria. This is main difference between anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration occurs only in cytoplasm. Aerobic respiration occurs in cytoplasm and mitochondria of the cell. Third point, glucose is incompletely oxidized in anaerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration, glucose is completely oxidized. Seen here, reaction process. Glucose is converted into ethyl alcohol and CO2 means ethyl alcohol is formed from glucose molecule means glucose is not completely oxidized, that is incompletely oxidized glucose molecule in anaerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, glucose is completely oxidized because glucose is converted into CO2 and water. So this is also most important difference between anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. Fourth point, anaerobic respiration metabolic water is not formed. Seen here, this reaction, water is not formed during anaerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, metabolic water is formed, means here water molecule is formed in aerobic respiration. In anaerobic respiration, water molecule is not formed. So metabolic water is not formed anaerobic respiration. Metabolic water is formed aerobic respiration. Up to this we detail discuss four different point. Anaerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration, point number fifth. End product of anaerobic respiration is complex, even toxic. Here the end product of anaerobic respiration is twice C2H5OH, means ethyl alcohol is complex and toxic in anaerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, end product are simple and non-toxic. Seen here, end product of aerobic respiration, CO2 and water, means both are evaporated products. So CO2 and water are simple non-toxic. This is also different between anaerobic and aerobic respiration. Point number seven, only 2 ATP form from single glucose molecule in anaerobic respiration. Seen here, reaction, one molecule of glucose oxidized to release only 2 ATP molecule in anaerobic respiration. And aerobic respiration, only 38 ATP formed from single glucose molecule. Seen here, single glucose molecule oxidized during the aerobic respiration to form 38 ATP molecule. So this is also different between anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. 2 ATP formed from single glucose molecule, 38 ATP formed from single glucose molecule. Point number 8, anaerobic respiration takes place in most of prokaryotes. Always remember, anaerobic respiration hi most of prokaryotes madhe hota. Example, bacteria, yeast and fungi are the best example of anaerobic respiration organism. But anaerobic respiration most of prokaryotes is, always remember, bacteria, fungi, yeast also takes place in anaerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration takes place in eukaryotes. Aerobic respiration takes place in eukaryotes. Example, algae, plant and animals. Up to this we detail discuss total 8 different points, anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. Hope that you understood everything. Now we learn general mechanism of anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. Mechanism of anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration, you know, complex organic food, that is glucose, 6 carbon compound, C6H12O6 glucose 6 carbon compound oxidized by process of glycolysis to form two molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound. This is the first step of mechanism of respiration, may be anaerobic or aerobic, both type of respiration. Glycolysis process occurs. Complex organic food like glucose 6 carbon is converted into two molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound by process of glycolysis. Respiration mechanism madhe glucose 6 carbon compound ha 2 molecule pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound madhe convert hoto ani pahili process occurs hote glycolysis. Hi process both anaerobic respiration madhe pan aste, aerobic respiration madhe pan aste. So this is the first process occurs in mechanism of respiration, in that glucose 6 carbon compound is converted into 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound. Always remember, the 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound is end product of glycolysis, and glucose 6 carbon is a raw material of glycolysis. Which one is raw material of glycolysis? Glucose 6 carbon compound. Which one is end product of glycolysis? 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound. This 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound undergoes anaerobic respiration to produce, with the help of microorganism yeast, produce enzyme zymase. Means microorganism yeast produce enzyme zymase from 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound is converted into 2C2H5OH, that is ethyl alcohol, plus 2CO2 molecule plus 2ATP molecule is the product of anaerobic respiration. Always remember, and after glycolysis, 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound is converted into 2 molecule of ethyl alcohol, that is twice C2H5OH, plus 2 molecule of CO2 plus 2ATP. These products are formed by presence of microorganism known as yeast. Such yeast is secreted by enzyme zymase. In presence of zymase, anaerobic respiration process takes place, that is fermentation process takes place, because anaerobic respiration is takes place by microorganisms, so called them fermentation process takes place. And during this process, 2 molecule of ethyl alcohol plus 2 molecule of CO2 plus 2 molecule of ATP are formed from 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound. This is the anaerobic respiration. Means anaerobic respiration consists of glycolysis is the first step, then 2 molecule of pyruvic acid is converted into 2 molecule of ethyl alcohol and 2 molecule of CO2 plus 2 molecule of ATP is done with the help of two steps: decarboxylation of pyruvic acid, then reduction process. Means pyruvic acid is decarboxylation to form acetaldehyde, and acetaldehyde reduced to form ethyl alcohol. So anaerobic respiration completed in formation of ethyl alcohol. First step is glycolysis, then decarboxylation, then reduction. So This is the anaerobic respiration and one of the type of fermentation of ethyl alcohol. Also, two molecule of pyruvic acid, three carbon compound undergoes anaerobic respiration in presence of lactic acid bacteria. Always remember, it is also one of the microorganism, lactic acid bacteria release lactic acid dehydrogenase enzyme from two molecule of pyruvic acid, three carbon compound produce lactic acid plus 2 ATP. Such lactic acid is in the form of 2CH3CHOH COOH, that is lactic acid plus 2 molecule of ATP in presence of lactic acid bacteria release lactic acid dehydrogenase enzyme. Means it is also one of the type of fermentation process and anaerobic respiration. 2 molecule of pyruvic acid, 3 carbon compound is converted into lactic acid plus 2 molecule of ATP. This is the anaerobic respiration. In this process, decarboxylation is not occurs, only reduction process occurs. Means pyruvic acid is directly reduced to form lactic acid. During this process, 2 ATP is released, means anaerobic respiration release 2 ATP. Maybe ethyl alcohol fermentation, maybe lactic acid fermentation. Up to this we detail discuss anaerobic respiration mechanism. No doubt glycolysis is the first step. Then two different types of fermentation, maybe ethyl alcohol fermentation. At that time yeast microorganism involved release zymase enzyme. When lactic acid fermentation, lactic acid bacteria involved to release lactic acid dehydrogenase enzyme. So anaerobic respiration is takes place in absence of free molecular oxygen. Now we learn aerobic respiration. No doubt aerobic respiration, first stage glycolysis, means glucose 6 carbon is converted into 2 molecule of pyruvic acid, 3 carbon compound in presence of free molecular oxygen gives 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus 38 ATP molecules. After glycolysis, two molecule pyruvic acid, three carbon compound are converted with the help of free molecular oxygen. 6CO2 molecule plus 6H2O molecule plus 38 ATP molecules in aerobic respiration. After glycolysis, three steps are occurs. First one is connecting link reaction, means pyruvic acid three carbon compound is not directly enter into the Krebs cycle, so pyruvic acid is undergoes acetylation to form acetyl COA compound. So connecting link reaction, that is acetylation of pyruvic acid, is the first step after glycolysis. Then Krebs cycle is second step after glycolysis. And third, ETS, means electron transfer system, also called as terminal oxidation, third step after glycolysis, means whole aerobic respiration process takes place. Glycolysis is the first step. connecting link reaction, second step, Krebs cycle, third step, and ATS or terminal oxidation, fourth step, then 6CO2, 6H2O plus 38 ATP is released, means mechanism of anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration, glycolysis is the first common process occurs during aerobic respiration as well as anaerobic respiration. After that, absence of free molecular oxygen, anaerobic respiration takes place, also called as fermentation. Maybe ethyl alcohol fermentation, maybe lactic acid fermentation. In presence of free molecular oxygen, aerobic respiration takes place. 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus 38 ATP molecule are formed. Up to this here, clear idea about mechanism of anaerobic and aerobic respiration. Hope that you understood everything. A review today's topic. We learn in today's lecture formation of ATP. There are three ways: phosphorylation, photophosphorylation, substrate level phosphorylation, oxidative phosphorylation. Also we detail discuss in this lecture significance of ATP, concept of respiration, two different ways of respiration, anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. We detail discuss difference between anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. Also, general mechanism of anaerobic respiration and aerobic respiration. On the basis of today's lecture, some exercise question noted here. MCQ question number 1. In eukaryotes, the complete oxidation of a molecule of glucose result in net gain of 2 molecule of ATP, 36 molecule of ATP, 4 molecule of ATP, 38 molecule of ATP eukaryotes madhe, 1 glucose molecule complete oxidation zalyanantar kiti gain hoto ATP cha, 2 molecule, 36 molecule, 4 molecule, 38 molecule, yes, 38 molecule of ATP, means D, 38 molecule of ATP is correct option. Second MCQ question, in prokaryotes, --- molecule of ATP are formed per molecule of glucose, oxidize 2 molecule, 4 molecule, 8 molecule, 24 molecule prokaryote madhe, how many molecule of ATP formed per molecule of glucose, eka glucose molecule madhun kiti ATP release hotat, yes, 2 molecules, means in prokaryote, 2 molecules of ATP are formed per molecule of glucose oxidized, means A, 2 molecule is correct option. Fourth MCQ, glycolysis takes place in cytoplasm, mitochondria, inner mitochondrial membrane, both A and B. Yes, glycolysis takes place in cytoplasm only, means A, cytoplasm is correct option. Which type of phosphorylation occurs in chloroplast? Yes, chloroplast madhe konte types of phosphorylation hota? Photophosphorylation, substrate level phosphorylation, oxidative phosphorylation, all of this? Yes, in chloroplast, photophosphorylation occurs. Photo means light, phosphorylation, formation of ATP. So photophosphorylation is the correct option, A-photophosphorylation. Identify the given mechanism structure and labeled A, B, C, D. Yes, the given mechanism structure known as mechanism of anaerobic and aerobic respiration mechanism. Here A is glycolysis, because glucose 6 carbon compound oxidized by process of glycolysis to form B means 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound. A glycolysis, B 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound. So 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound undergoes anaerobic respiration, produce ethyl alcohol plus 2 CO2 molecule, plus here D means 2 ATP molecule. 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound means B undergoes aerobic respiration in presence of free molecular oxygen, produce 6 CO2 molecule plus 6 H2O molecule plus C means 38 ATP molecule. A glycolysis, B 2 molecule of pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound, D 2 ATP molecule, C 38 ATP molecule. Up to this, today's lecture completed. Hope that you understood everything. If you like the video, then you can subscribe my YouTube Bio Info channel. Tap the bell icon and like the video. If any doubt about today's lecture, mention in comment box. Thank you.